Hello, Facebook family. This is Dr. Oscar Moses, pastor of the Calvary Baptist Church in Salt Lake City, Utah. This morning, many of you have heard we've experienced an earthquake in Utah, something I've never experienced before. It woke me up out of my sleep. And I'm quite sure that many of you said the same three words that I said. Lord, help us. Help is a common need. And there comes a time in all of our lives that we need help. Psalm 121 says, I will lift my eyes to the hills from which cometh my help. All of my help cometh from the Lord who created the heavens and the earth. This psalm is an interesting psalm. Scholars don't know who really wrote it. Some say that it was David. Some call it the traveler's psalm. Some call it the military psalm. But we do know that as these travelers were going to the hills of Jerusalem, they would set their sights on Mount Zion. The mountains were seen everywhere. There are three things that I see in those two verses. Let me give them to you. Number one, the lifting. The psalmist says, I will lift my eyes. In the Hebrew or Akkadic, the meaning simply means to long or to look with desire and not with dread. That's the lifting of the eyes, to long with desire and not dread. But it also lifts up the location. I will lift my eyes to the hills. And these travelers would look unto the hills where the Ark of the Covenant was. And the Ark of the Covenant was symbolic or it represented the presence of God. Here's the lesson. The lesson is not for us to look at the hills for help. The lesson is for us to look to the one that created the hills. That God is so providential that he's able to uphold his creation, and that God literally involves himself in whatever we're going through right now. Why am I saying this today? Because our help comes from the Lord. It doesn't come from FEMA. It doesn't come from the White House. It doesn't come from the scientists in the lab. Our help comes from the Lord. God is a very present help in the time of trouble. The Hebrew writer says in Hebrews 4:16, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. America, if we ever needed God's help, we sure do need it now. What is God saying to us? What do I believe he's saying to us in a time like this? I believe that God is simply saying to us, can you hear me now? In 2007, Verizon launched this America's wireless network, and the test launch man was seen coming out of a sewer with a phone saying, can you hear me now? He was in the mountains in the Arctic cold weather with a cell phone saying, can you hear me now? He was in a remote jungle with a phone saying, can you hear me now? I'm simply saying this, is that God is speaking loudly. And no matter where we are at on this globe, he's asking us that question. Can you hear me now? Our Father in heaven, we thank you. We recognize that help is a common need. And we recognize that you have promised to be our help. And so God, as we look unto you, we don't look at our problems, but we look at the one who is the problem solver. Give us strength that our faith might be increased. Jesus is our Savior, and we thank you for his sufficient sacrifice on the cross of Calvary. And God, I pray for someone who has not heard you, that they would open up their spiritual ears, eyes, and heart, that they might hear you now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.